Greetings, everyone. I am Karan, Ahuja, a fifth-year PhD student at Carnegie Mellon University. Today, I'm going to talk to you about my work on hand pose prediction, depth estimation, and touch classification from capacitive images. This work was done by my collaborators Paul Streli and Christian Holz. Capacitive sensing has become the most prevalent input modality to record contact masks when detecting touch input. For this purpose, commonly a drive and sensing layer is integrated into a device's surface, such as phones, tablets, or even whiteboard screens. In a nutshell, these systems work by estimating the mutual capacitance between fingers and the touch controller sense lines. The key takeaway is that these measurements, when visualized as a 2D image, result in a low-resolution finger imprint that are proportional to the distance to the user's fingers and hands. This generated capacitive image allows devices, such as our smartphones and tablets, to locate multiple 2D touch locations. However, these 2D coordinates are only the manifestation of the much more complex 3D configuration of the whole hands, which capacitive touch devices so far remain oblivious to. In this work, we introduce the problem of reconstructing a 3D hand from capacitive images, which encode the sparse observations captured by touch sensors. Prior works have looked at various approaches to capture this 3D hand pose. For instance, DeepFisheye uses a fisheye camera mounted to the touchscreen to predict which finger is touching the screen. Gloucester et al. Proposed a stretch sensing glove using a matrix of capacitive sensors embedded into a flexible glove. All these prior works required the need of additional hardware, such as cameras or gloves, for 3D hand pose estimation. In response, I present TouchPose, a multitask convolutional neural network for 3D hand pose estimation from only the capacitive images without any external sensors. To improve the generalizability of the model, it is trained across modalities that capture depth, skeletal hand pose, and validity of touch events. While it is intuitive that there exist multiple hand poses for a given input, especially in the case of few fingers touching the screen, TouchPose aims to recover the best fitting hand pose based on the collected data in a least square sense. To collect data for the deep learning module, the data capture rig was configured with a mutual capacitance touch panel, 16-bit touch digitizer, leap motion for ground truth hand skeleton capture, and a time of flight connect to record depth data. This facilitated the creation of a cross-modal dataset with over 65,000 sets of capacitive images, depth maps, and annotated 3D hand poses from 10 participants over a variety of input poses. TouchPose recovers hand poses with an endpoint error of 19.6 mm per joint, which drops to 14.4 mm when considering joints corresponding to fingers in contact with the surface. It can work in both portrait and landscape orientation of devices and can generalize across participants and hand gestures that it has never seen before. Here you can see the points of contact with the touchscreen are darker in the depth map. It can also reconstruct 3D hands from palm-based interactions as well, and at times the forearm as well. The same capacitive image can result from different hand poses due to variation in the orientation of fingers not touching the screen. In such case, TouchPose predicts the most likely hand pose for such fingers. TouchPose can enable a wide variety of applications. Using the estimated full hand pose, it can distinguish between intentional and inadvertent touch events, as seen in this typing app. It can also be used as a tool for character animation. From our poses, we can recognize different hand gestures that trigger control sequences and animation routines. TouchPose can also speed up the interaction with UI widgets through gestural input. Here, the pinch of the finger can be used to control a slider. In the same vein, the yaw and pitch can both be used to rotate a 3D model along different axes. Similarly, finger angles and gestures can be integrated together in a drawing app. Here, the finger angle changes the stroke width, and the palm can be used as an eraser. In future, TouchPose can be extended to trackpads, larger tabletops, and even non-planar surfaces such as smartphones with curved screens and VR controllers. Thank you for watching. Please refer to the paper for full details.